Hello everyone, I'm TC Eckstein of TC Eckstein Cafe TV. Welcome to this year's season of new shows, of new promos, of new. We are starting a whole new schedule of events and bringing you all new information, new people, new opportunities, and new views. So, I'm glad you tuned in today. Get your coffee on, my brothers and sisters. We got ours. And we have in the studio today, special guest and partner, of course, Mr. Dion Soldier Ballard. And we're gonna sit and talk. We also have another guest coming in a little bit later. And I'm gonna keep that a secret for now. And stay tuned because we have many, many more things happening, including the awards is definitely happening this year, and many performances we're going to cover, and live events, and just great things going on in Springfield. And since I have moved closer to Focus Springfield Television Station here in Springfield, Mass., things are going to be off the hook. We are going to really be right up and close because I'm in downtown now. So ain't no stopping me. What's you tell me something's going on? TC's right there. So keep on watching. Stay tuned. Welcome everyone to today's edition of TC Eckstein Cafe TV. It's TC Eckstein here, vocalist, and we're here with Dion Soldier Ballard. Hey Dion!
Hey, how you doing, TC? Hi everyone.
I'm good. Hey! We're back. With a whole new season, and we've got some goodies for you, I'm telling you. So Dion, tell us what's going on in Dion's world.
Oh, Dion's worlds have been really busy. Still working on No More Bullying Suicide, the documentary. And we have a lot of nice artists that's gonna be on the soundtrack. And I'm also working on the music for the soundtrack.
Wow.
So I've been busy doing that.
Yeah.
I've been also, you know, I manage Dr. Bradford Howard.
And Godfather.
Godfather of music. And we've been doing a lot of things. We form a group called Deuteronomy, Doc and Deuteronomy 28. And
excuse me. Y'all ain't playing. Yeah, talking about Deuteronomy 28. Now you gotta know something if you know what that's all about.
That's right. So yeah, we're working on that. We're working on music on that, and we've been doing some rehearsals and stuff of that nature. And we're gonna get him on the show too.
Yes,
so.
We are. He's coming soon. He's coming soon. We've got lots of projects we're working on with him, and he said to make sure I'm aware that he doesn't just do gospel music, so I gotta make sure we put that in the show today. Doc Bradford Howard Jr., my godfather, he's a very, very heavy-hitting, award-winning musician,
yes.
And he's very established. He has restaurants that named the Doc Burger after him. And there's something else they named after him, too, in the restaurant. I forget. It's another, I think it's a taco or something.
Yeah, it's a taco. I think it's a taco.
He just takes over. It's going to become Doc's restaurant.
I know. He's like a Brandon Giant. He brands himself very well.
We've got the awards show coming up in November. That's going to be in Hartford, Connecticut, that's going to be great. We collaborated with him on that, so that's going to be a great award show.
Yes.
And I'm looking forward to that. And just, you know, doing more work with him and everything, and with you. I mean, we've always stayed collaborated and listed soldiers together with TC Eckstein Cafe Productions. And I mean, we're a force to reckon with.
Yeah,
but we're here for the community.
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
We fight for the community,
yes,
right?
Yes, we do. So yeah, lots been going on, but you know, in between we've had some rough patches. I mean,
of course.
You know, we all got things going on in our lives, and at the same time as working on these things, we've had little setbacks here, little setbacks there. But in the long run, there's been some great things happening, some great improvements.
Of course, yeah, great improvements.
So it's just a matter of a little bit of patience and stuff. But it's been a minute since we've been back here in the studio
together.
But it's okay. Yeah,
I missed it.
Now we're back, and we're back. The time is opening up for us, so we'll be able to do it, and even more projects. And I don't even want to tell you all about that stuff. Y'all just wait and
see. Yeah, you got to wait and see.
Because
we've been talking about
surprises.
Right, we got a lot of surprises.
We got surprises for you.
Yes, we do.
This summer, even though we're sweltering and melting, like I'm melting now, you know, like, it's worth it because we're still getting our work done and we still have a little time for some fun and relaxation. And but, you know, getting it done during this time, it'll all benefit having that time to relax a little bit once fall hits and everything's just airing.
I know.
And then we're like, people are like, wow, that's new. You just did it. And we're like, that was done a while ago.
I know,
they don't even know.
We've been grinding on that a long
time. It takes the time to do it. And then once it all comes out, we're still working on stuff and people don't realize oh, they work so hard. Oh, you have no idea. It takes a while. And then you got editing and production involved and all that stuff. So, I mean, things are kind of time consuming, but it's so much worth it because we love to do it to give back. So, so you want to let the people know what's going on with Spoken Revelations and Enlistic Soldiers, any upcoming events?
We have a Spoken Revelations. We have a docuseries that's out.
Yes, and you were telling me.
It's on slavery. I know you're going to have a episode in that. And what we're doing, we just doing it like instead of just the spiritual lectures, we are just doing it in a documentary format. So we have scriptures up.
Yeah.
Things of that nature.
Oh, that's gonna be nice.
It's so enlightening, and you know, we're gonna have different speakers talking about slavery, and when I'm talking about slavery from the Bible standpoint of, you know, where it could be anything that you enslaved to, that and you enslaved to sin. So we're talking about different types of sin in the Docker series. So that's been rewarding.
It's a lot that ties into that people aren't aware of. They just think of slavery and shackles and chains, but there's slavery with your mind.
Right, right.
And that's what's still going on today.
I know.
People keep saying the 400 years is up, and I think to myself, what you talking about? There's still some slavery going on.
Right,
there's a lot of people in the Matrix walking around.
Exactly.
And there's some shackles and chains on their brains. So,
that's right.
I mean, you don't even have to be black for that.
Everywhere. What did they say? Prison Planet?
That's why I love the show that, you know, that we work on with Stay Woke.
Yeah, I know. Oh, it's a beautiful show. Love that show.
Stay Woke is to inform you and awaken you.
Yeah.
Because this was predicted. The Great Awakening was predicted many years ago.
Many years.
And these devil people knew this was coming.
Mm-hmm.
They knew this age was coming. But they're looking forward to this age hurrying up, finishing, so they can do what they want to do and get into this fifth dimension they're working on, which is your 5G and all this other stuff. That's going to mess people up.
Yeah.
But they think they're getting away with all this stuff, but just trust and believe and have faith. Because
that's right.
They're not going to get away with all it. There's no way.
There's
not going to happen. But in the meantime, you need to awaken yourself. You need to wake up and realize. And it's not just spiritually. It's an awakening. It's a mentality awakening.
Yeah.
A knowledge of self, who you are, where you come from. That's why history is vital.
Right.
I mean, you know, we... Growing up as kids, a lot of times we didn't want to hear history.
It was boring in school.
But it's so pertinent to understanding the happenings of today because what is said in the Bible? There's nothing new under the sun.
There's nothing new.
Nothing new under the sun. What's happened before will happen again. Even that killer, Jim Jones, that he put that sign up in Guyana when he enslaved all those people down there with mind control. What was the sign he had up? It said, those who don't know their history are doomed to repeat it.
Repeat it.
That sign is telling you right to your face.
Yep.
If you don't know where you came from, you're doomed to go through the same old stuff your ancestors went through, blah, blah, blah. So, I mean, we can't change the world. We know that. But we want to be a part of the movement and helping people to be awakened.
Right.
So I'm very glad that we're on the same page.
I know.
With that.
Yeah, we definitely on the same page.
We're on
with
the
that.
Same page. With
my sister, we work together. You know, awakening folks. Even on the internet. Even on the internet, right?
Uh-huh.
And you know, with the show. the Ustream show, Stay Woke. I mean, it's just a lot of good information on that Ustream channel.
The thing is, you know what's weird is this past month, out of all the months, suddenly my views stopped halfway through the month.
Oh, that's another topic.
They completely stopped, and I said, people are still watching my show. I know they are, but somebody did something to freeze all my views.
Oh yeah.
Because people were like, I'm still watching your show. And I'm like, I hope so, because every day I check, it says no views. For like halfway into the month. And I'm like, I know people are watching my show. They froze some of the views because they don't want it getting out there.
They don't want it to be.
But that's okay. It's still going to be up there.
Oh,
and you can still watch. I don't care.
Please watch it. Support it even more.
If it says no views on it, don't pay that no mind.
Yeah.
They doing stuff to try to get it off.
Yes.
Just like people that post things on YouTube, they're starting to pull a lot of the footage that we get off of YouTube. And these people are telling you that you can't monetize your page. They'll take the monetization thing off.
Yeah, they'll take the commercials off.
They won't let you get paid for it.
Right.
And a lot of them, they're shutting down their pages, but they're like, I'm not going to stop. I just invent a new page.
Easily.
And keep it. And, you know, and it drives these YouTube people crazy. But what they're going to do eventually is pull YouTube, unfortunately.
Yeah,
so, but until they do that, it is so vital for you and me and Dion and all the people that are interested in the subject and want to be awakened to watch as much as you can and research as much as you can. And don't just go by what you see on the shows.
Right.
Research it for yourself.
Yeah,
if it seems like something like you're like, well, I don't believe that. If it seems like something like, I don't believe that, or wow, that's a little bit too outrageous, or that's conspiracy theories. You know what? I'm not challenging you, because it's up to you whether you want to learn it or not.
Right.
I'm not playing a game. I'm not trying to challenge nobody. I'm just going to say that I'll put it out there. It's subjective information and objective. You do with it what you want. But you can't ever say nobody never showed this to me.
Right.
Nobody never put it out there.
Yeah.
And then you have the opportunity to research it and, you know, come up with your own conclusion.
That's right.
But at least somebody put it there for you.
Yeah.
And I think that's our job. That's our purpose in life.
It is our job.
If we learn something, we're supposed to give back and help other people.
That's
because we don't want everybody else to suffer
and
go through, or just be walking blindly.
I know.
We got the next generation to look out for.
I know, don't we?
Yeah. And it's like, I just can't sit back and just let it happen and oh, well, whoever's going to burn in hell, going to burn
it. That's right. That's
right. I just can't do it.
Me either.
A lot of people just sit
so
back, they're going to burn hell. And, you know, like, I'm at the point where I don't even call myself Christian anymore. I don't want the title because the research I've done.
Mm-hmm.
You know how we've discussed the 501c3.
Right.
And how that's part of the system and everything.
Yeah.
So I don't want that title, because all these years, the churches have never preached a lot of things that have come up to our awakening.
Awakening. Yeah, they kept a lot of stuff out.
They kept a lot of stuff out. And it's because.
And they knew it.
They knew it. Not only did they knew it, but they had. The only way they could get the funding or the use of church was by accepting to get the 501c. They had to agree that they would not preach on this or this or this. So, I mean, I personally would never have gone along with that, if you know.
No, me.
And I feel tricked. I feel that it's an institution I can't trust. And why should we? I mean, it's the same institution that was used to enslave us from the jump street. So, I mean, you got the whip in one hand and the Bible in the other, and that's how we were enslaved. So how can you trust the messenger with the same message they used to enslave you? I mean, you know, it's common sense, kind of, for a lot of people. So I don't label myself Christian. I love the Most High.
Yeah.
And I believe in the Al-Mashiach, the Christ, which just simply means the Anointed One.
Right.
But I don't walk around praising anybody except the Most High. Because if you go by the Ten Commandments, which is the law that was given down to Moses, that God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he said, I never change.
Yeah.
And so how are you going to go from the Old Testament saying, I am the Lord your God, the God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob and Moses. I never change. I never give my honor and glory with nobody else. Right. To the New Testament, where he give everything over. And you know, and then everybody's turning to the east and they're worshiping the sun.
Yeah.
And is it the sun or is it the sun?
Is it S-O-N, I mean, or is it S-U-N?
Thank you. You gotta be very careful. You gotta
be careful.
Read between the lines. You gotta know what you're looking at. Because for years and years we've been taught in these facilities, these 501c3 facilities, to follow certain scriptures they just give us in little excerpts, and then in between that they want a tithing, and that's another thing you gotta research on. So I'm sorry, I'm not trying to bash you guys, but you know, I can understand this new movement of people going to atheism because it's exactly what they want.
Mm-hmm.
It's exactly what they want. If you say, oh, they've been lying to us for years, I'm an atheist now. That's what they want you to do.
That's what they want you to do.
No, be smart. Instead of that, research. Research. Right. There's got to be a creator.
Right.
So you can't tell me we just came out of thin air.
No.
And you can't trust science. Science is like trying to be God.
Yeah, right.
You know, and even they've admitted that old man, the guy in the wheelchair that died, I forget his name.
Oh, Stephen Hawkins.
Yeah, he even admitted, we're about to open up something that has to do with God that we don't need to be messing with before he died.
Right.
And so that's an atheist telling you.
He's telling you.
There's something that got to do with God that we ain't got no business touching.
That's right.
So even if he said that, then there you go.
Right.
I mean, what's not to understand? Science did not create this. Something else created all this. So, but anyway, we got so much more to talk about.
We got a lot to talk about. Yeah, we can.
But the cafe, we're going to talk. We're going to do more with Spoken Revelations.
Yes, we are.
And we're going to show things from Spoken Revelations.
Yes.
We're going to be showing you post-production things happening.
Yes.
Random radio activities happening. Things with Doc Bradford Howard.
Yes.
Things all around Springfield and around beyond.
Mm-hmm.
New stars and people that are up and rising, coming artists that are going to be spotlight features on them. And things around our community that are happening. Speaking of that, I'm going to bring up the Jazz Roots Festival that's coming up Saturday, August 10th. Love the festival, help make it happen. They're asking for volunteers. You can hit up Springfield Jazz Roots Festival on Facebook or just Google them and contact them, get in touch with them, and sign up to be a volunteer if you'd like to be. And then they have the Fresh Paint Springfield thing going on, and that's at Tower Square second floor. You can view the gallery, which is in the Art for Soul gallery.
Oh yeah,
Rosemary Woods.
That's your girl.
Rosemary Tracy Woods, that's my girl.
Yeah, that's
yep.
your girl right there.
So you can't really see this clearly, but they're having this big thing in Springfield called Fresh Paint Springfield.
Mm-hmm.
You can look that up on Facebook too, or Google it, where they're painting all these beautiful murals all over
town.
That's by the people of the residents of Springfield are coming together through the Springfield Cultural Society.
Oh.
They're putting it on and they're asking for artists to get involved. So look up Springfield Cultural Society. Actually, what I'm going to do is these links, I'm going to post them all at the end of the show so you can easily go onto those links and see what they have and sign up. And if you're an artist, you want to get involved. You want to get your work out there and, you know, see what they have to offer, because they do a lot more than just the painting, the fresh paint thing that's going on. They have opportunities for your art to get noticed. And I mean, all over Massachusetts, not just Springfield. So you want to check that out. Welcome back to TC Eckstein Cafe TV. I'm your host, TC Eckstein, and I am your TV show main person. being silly right now. I miss being back on the air with you guys, and it's just nice. So it's just, I'm very excited also about the season and all the upcoming things. As you guys can see, I chopped my hair all off because, you know, I got something to say about my sisters out there. Listen, many of you know I'm a jazz singer, and I've done all different kinds of genres of music. And over the years, I've worn the wigs, I've worn the weaves, I've done the braids. And as you can see, my hair is kind of thin and stuff. Like, you know, it's all done up now, but naturally it's a poof curly ball. And I just said, I'm going natural. I'm 54 now, and I'm not doing it no more. And if there's one thing I could tell you guys, it's do what you can to go natural. I'm seeing all these things happening to girls where their hair is falling out, these chemicals are seeping into your scalp when you wear the fake stuff. But we're gonna have videos that tell you all about that stuff. And I know, trust me, I love my wigs. I used to love doing all the different styles and everything. But it's not good for you. It's really not good for us. And it's teaching us and our young girls today that we're less valued if we don't have that fake stuff. So we don't need it. I mean, this is me, like it or leave it, you know? And I'm with it, let it grow longer and take care of your vitamins and all that. And I'm just happy, it's like I can breathe now. So anyway, welcome back to the show. Continue watching, because we're gonna cover all kinds of things. Health issues, you know I'm still down with the American Heart Association. We care about cancer, breast cancer, pancreatic cancer, colon cancer, all forms of cancer. We're very concerned about Alzheimer's, and especially a lot of social issues going on, especially globally and on in and around our community. Things that are happening for our youth, to the elderly. We're going to be covering a lot of major things, and we want you to participate and be involved. And if you have any information you'd like to lend us on it, feel free to contact us at tcxsteincafe@gmail.com. And we're going to get back to the show now. So enjoy, sit back, and get your coffee on, my brothers and sisters. Anything else you want to bring up, Dion?
I think I covered as much as possible.
For now,
we want to keep things a little secret until we get it in fruition.
Get more, right.
Yeah, and then
right.
We'll put it out there for
but
you.
But I did want to talk to you about, we got a little time here, what did you think? Did you watch it yet, When They See Us? The documentary by Ava DuVernay. You got
like
Netflix, right?
Yeah, I do have it,
but
I haven't gotten a chance to see it.
You get me mad at you.
I know. I'm slacking. I'm really slacking.
It's very powerful. It's very emotional.
She's a very powerful director.
Yeah, well, this one, she knocked it out of the park.
She did, out the park.
I have to see it.
I'm
y'all gonna laugh, but TC has watched it at least 25 times, and each time I watch it,
is it that good to you?
It's so good.
Wow.
When I go home, I'll watch it again.
I have to watch it.
It's a four-part series. It's so deep, and it brings you right inside what happened to these four kids. They called them the Central Park Five back in the day. It's about them,
right.
But they're now called the Exonerated Five. And the whole story is the kids telling you from their point of view exactly what went down. And showing you the insides of the court case and everything, and their exoneration and all that. It's caused so much controversy. It's so huge on Netflix right now that woman that was the one that tried to, you know, the one that had them locked up in the first place, she's losing her job and her book rights and all this other stuff's getting taken away.
Good.
It's very deep, and it's upsetting a lot of people. On both sides, you know, there's a race issue involved, but it's not just race, because it's a matter of the incarceration and the justice system. Race is very much involved.
Yes,
but the justice legal system. When you see this film, you're gonna see what goes on like that inside these prisons. It's just horrible.
Right.
Deplorable. And these were babies. You gotta watch it, dear. It's called When They See Us. It's on Netflix, and I do have the trailer and stuff that runs on the TV show, so.
Is my mom here?
It's just us. You and us. Who you were in the bark with?
I don't know names. I just got lost.
Where did you see the lady?
One lady.
The female jogger was severely beaten and raped.
Every black male who was in the park last night is a suspect. I need all of them.
What's going on with my son?
Your son was involved in a rape in Central Park.
No, wait a second.
Wait a second.
They saw you rape the lady.
I didn't see a lady or hit anyone.
I didn't see any lady.
Kevin.
I didn't see any lady.
I want to see my son right now. Right now.
Whatever they said I did, I didn't.
I know. Zoning on the road. Nothing these boys state matches the central facts of the crime. All we need is for one to tie this whole thing together.
These tapes are not as clean as the state would have you believe.
There is injustice happening here.
There is not one shred of evidence.
Imagine the frenzy of these teenagers ripping off her
car. They are innocent of these crimes.
They are guilty.
Why are they doing us like this?
What other way they ever do us?
And I haven't looked back.
I've been having these dreams. I keep hearing these footsteps. And they come in closer and closer.
That's me coming to bring you home.
They said if I went along with it, that I could go home. And that's all I wanted.
The police will do anything. Lie on us, they will lock us up, they will kill us.
This is my life.
I don't think we should admit to something that we didn't do.
Okay, we keep fighting.
But yeah, you gotta watch it. And when you watch it, we're gonna come back.
We'll come back.
Me and him are gonna talk about it.
Yes,
we ain't gonna talk about it till you see it.
No,
I want you to see it.
I wanna see it this week.
You see it tonight when you go home. You're making me upset. You better watch it. And then there's a follow-up interview show on Netflix with Oprah Winfrey there talking. Because she's executive producer on it.
Oh, wow.
And her, Ava DuVernay, and all the original cast. And the real guys come out and talk with interacting with the audience. And it both of them are so powerful. But this one, out of all five kids, this is the one kid, Corey, his real name's Kari Wise, but they call him Corey Wise. He went through the most because he's 16 years old. And so they tried him as an adult.
And
he went to adult prison. And he wasn't even, he was not even on the list.
Wow.
He just actually went down to the police station looking out for his friend. So this poor kid, oh my gosh, he went through beatings. And every transfer he went through, he got beat again. He was put in isolation most of the time. Horrific. He's the final fourth part. They save that for the end. And I mean, you better have your Kleenex because you're going to be like, whoa. But it's just so deep. And then these kids, one of them, the kid Raymond Santana, he started a clothing apparel line. Many of them, most of them, all but one. Corey still lives in New York City. The other four moved to Atlanta, and they're doing very well. They're successful down there since they've been exonerated. But he started his own clothing apparel line.
Oh, nice.
And I'm getting my T-shirt. The T-shirt
I
says,
gotta support.
The five boys' names are Yusef Salam, Antron McCray, Raymond Santana. I remember their names. That's how much I've watched it. Corey Weiss and Kevin Richardson. I'm ordering it in 2 days. And I'm just so supportive of that film. Because I remember in 1989 when that went down. I used to hang out in New York a lot. And I got family in New York. And that was at the time of KRS-One.
Yeah, of course.
You know, especially Fight the Power.
And the kid,
one of the kid, Yusef, he had the high top fade. And it was real
high
top. You
know,
and they had the African necklaces. And so it was a time where people just was cutting up, listening to music. And they kept using the term they were wilding out when they convicted them. Right, and right. Wilding out, there's a TV show today called Wilding Out
with Nick Cannon.
Nick Cannon.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean you're out killing and hurting people in the park or nothing.